Yo, what is up, guys? S Future here. In this video, we are reacting to The Grey by Bad Omens. This is their last single for the album. It has to be. The album comes out on the 25th, I think. Yeah, on the 25th. That's in 2 days. God damn, I gotta react to that. This is the last single for the album. How many singles have there been? Five? The Death of Peace of Mind, Artificial Suicide, What Do You Want From Me, Like a Villain, and The Grey. Five singles for an album. Is the album going to be long? I mean, I'd assume it's over like 15 songs, right? I'm hoping we get a pretty big album. Either way, it's going to be amazing. If you guys are interested in me reacting to the Bad Omens album when it comes out, subscribe to the channel and turn post notifications on, and we will react to it when it comes out. I'm excited to see what kind of vibe we get here, because the singles have been very versatile between each other. You know, The Death of Peace of Mind was a very... like, I didn't give that song enough credit, by the way. Like, I reacted to The Death of Peace of Mind, and I liked it. I didn't dislike it, but I didn't, like, hype it up that much. And one of you guys commented and was like, I think the more you listen to it, the more you're going to like it. And I liked it enough to where I added it to my playlist. So I was listening to The Death of Peace of Mind, and it got hooked on me. And I've been listening to it a lot, and it's just, it's a really beautiful song. And then you got Artificial Suicide, which is, like, a really heavy banger. And then What Do You Want From Me is my least favorite out of the singles. It was a little different. I didn't dislike it. It just wasn't my favorite. Like a Villain was amazing. Amazing. That chorus is great from Like a Villain. And now we got The Grey. So I'm excited to see if this is going to be like a really heavy one, or we're going to get some more melodic, clean vocals. Or maybe both. Some good like versatility within the song. But yeah, either way, guys, if you guys are interested, check out my gaming channel linked in the description. I make funny moment videos with my friends and my girlfriend on there.
Could have been a church here!
We don't like me a fucking atheist!
If you guys aren't interested, go check it out. It is linked in the description. Other than that, guys, this is The Grey by Bad Omens. Let's get into it. Okay, so we're getting some clean vocals here and at the start. So you got a pretty cool, simple, rocky riff here. Like, that's something I noticed in Like a Villain, the main riff of that song. It was very, like, it sounded like a very, like, radio-friendly riff. And I'm pretty sure that's what they did with Like a Villain. I think that song was meant to be their, like, radio play song. Because, you know, albums gotta have that at least a little bit, I think. Most albums in metal and rock, they always go for like 2-3 songs that are very, you know, radio friendly, kind of like radios would play them, radio stations. And Like a Villain, that I feel like that was their radio play song. And this riff, it's good, but and it's simple and good, and it's kind of got that vibe to it.
Even the scores, and I let it all go fall apart. And every step forward, put a little more sword in your heart, yeah. Looking sideways when I say I'm okay with the past. But I'm afraid of what I might say if you ask. Gave you way too many chances, you wrapped the room up. Got everything I could want, but it wasn't enough.
Strange. we'll have pause for good. Part of the video is really cool. We get a breakdown, right? And we didn't like a villain. It's very short. This kind of feels like the Death of Peace of Mind bridge to the breakdown. Alright guys, that was The Grey by Bad Omens. I am very proud of them. Sorry, I got a cold. I'm very proud of them for going all clean there. Because, you know, in Like a Villain, there was a couple during the breakdown. In like maybe, you know, before the breakdown, there were like a couple scream lines. And there were like two or three lines. And like, they're very good touches, but it kind of felt like, oh, we're having a very clean, rocky song. We need to add some heavy lines to cater to our original audience, like our fans. Because I don't know much about Bad Omens, but from what I saw in Dethrone, that's the oldest song by them I've checked out. They used to be like really, really heavy all the time, right? I mean, have they always been this versatile? Like, I don't know much, you know, background on them, so I'm not gonna give thoughts that I don't really know about. But from what I can tell is they are kind of going out of their comfort zone and getting a little bit more cleaner on some of these songs. And it just shows how good Noah is as a vocalist also. Like, he is such a legendary vocalist with his versatility. Like, it's so strange going to react to Dethrone and hearing all those heavy, low screams. And then going to a song like this where it's like really clean and angelic and just beautiful vocals. So what I was saying was, I'm very proud that there was no scream lines in this song, and there wasn't a breakdown. It really felt like they jumped like fully into that like clean rock sound for this one, instead of like the villain where they, you know, like blended in with their like normal sound, you know what I mean? So yeah, like I said in the intro, that really, it felt like that's like another like radio friendly song. If anything, it's this one. It's all clean vocals, no breakdown. The riff is really good and simple, and it's not too heavy. So it's like, this would be a very good radio play song. It's where they get the radio streams. I'm really excited for the album to come out. It comes out in 2 days. I'll be checking it out shortly after it comes out. So like I said, if you guys are interested in me checking out the album, subscribe and turn post notifications on. My favorite single, now that all the singles are out, I'm going to say my favorite single, it's not What Do You Want From Me, it's not The Grey, it's not The Death of Peace of Mind, even though it has grown on me so much, and I do love the chorus a lot, and the breakdown. And you know, you're probably thinking it's Artificial Suicide. No, you know, Artificial Suicide is the heaviest one out of the singles, but my favorite's Like a Villain. That's my favorite single of them all. It's, that chorus is just so catchy. I sing it all the damn time. We got clean verses, and then we got, like I said, a couple heavy lines, and the breakdown was really good. It was just short. So yeah, I'm gonna say Like a Villain was my favorite single out of them all. The Grey was still really good. I would not be surprised if I heard that on like a rock radio station. But yeah, guys, in the comments down below, let me know what you guys thought about that song. Let me know what your favorite single is. Actually, comment down below what your favorite single is out of the five. I'm excited to get into the album. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the future.